when I started to see that, I started to change the way I thought. I started to heal the way I think I needed to be healed. And when I started to see that, I felt very honored that I was, that I could recognize that enough to let anything that I had in, I let it go. And that's what I want to share with you guys, is that I started to witness what elders were saying with old people when they don't share the teachings with you. I started to witness elders share the teachings. And I thought, that's what elders talk about. That's what they meant. They let it go, and they were sharing these teachings because the prophecies were coming through from Crazy Horse to City Wolf, what they were talking about, from Woboka. Woboka was the ghost dance, and many of you guys know about that. On that November 20th, when I was running across, when I was coming across the bridge, a sniper was chasing me. You guys may have seen him, Kyle Thompson. That moment is when I had this acknowledgement that during that ghost dance, our runners didn't make it out. And as I got across that bridge, he was stopped by water protectors. And when he got out, that drone was coming, my drone was coming back, and my drone captured him getting out of his vehicle with his gun. And I was only about maybe 100 yards from him. And I got out, and I saw that, and I was wondering if I was going to get shot catching my drone. Maybe I should let my drone go. But that drone had the footage that we were able to show the world of what happened that day. And I grabbed that footage. Right before I grabbed that footage, also Cody Hall came up to me, and he told me you need to get out of here and get that footage out. So people were, there was many things that were going through my mind. When he was chasing me, I could hear about 100 people screaming, "Run, Myron, run." You know, can you imagine that in your head as I was going? This is what I heard, and I'm thinking, the only other time I heard that is when we saw those mercenaries come down and take two of our people right from the camp, kidnap them, zip tie them, throw them back in the ATVs and take off. We all watched it and witnessed it. And I thought, well, I'm a big guy, I'm going to have to do a lot more than that today. You're out there with the guys that are black ops, you know, for my size. They look like they've been throwing horses around, you know, big guys. So they brought a lot of people in, special forces, you know, about different agencies, border control. There's so many people they brought in. That's the moment that really changed the way I thought of things when I was leaving the camp. I switched into a few different cars, get out of camp, get the footage out. Prairie Nights Hotel is going to be a different place than I ever see. It's not just your standard hotel. This was a place where the tribe had the opportunity, and it did, and it used it to help us help the tribe by having a simple internet and a place to stay warm and work. So, you know, the way we see things today, be appreciative of what you have, if you didn't have it. I'm wondering what would happen if we didn't have it there. The outcome would be different than you guys all would have seen. So, these are the things I'm sharing with you. Indian country is already working without. That's why it went so hard. We were in the digital divide already. Lack of internet, lack of cell service. So it was nothing new. We have already had this training ground for 500 years. You know, so the thing was, that was psychological training ground. We had to be spiritually connected. I had to follow the protocols. And also be, you know, more kind than I was before to myself. There's a lot of guys see them, so that I wasn't getting much sleep when I was out there. So I started listening to people around me as well. Well, those are just some of the stories that I have and many of our relatives have as well. I had a young crew with me that's been helping me right before my second crew of digital smoke signals. And I learned from that crew. We started using social media and pushing it out younger, faster with our younger crew, which is our young ones out here know a lot more. And I'm not going to jump up there and say, I know it. I'm going to bring them up and help them. I'm going to empower them. I want you to empower your young people to do it. Show them how to do it. Talk to them about how to. This is what I learned out there more than ever, because they're the movement behind us. They're the ones that ran and started the fire and kept it going, and now it's inside us now. Even though they put the fires out at the camp, the fire is still inside us. So we're going to get started with these videos here. These videos are still fresh. The footage is all the way up from 2 weeks ago. So if you've got any questions afterwards, we'll give them some questions. And keep an open mind. And it's not a real graphic for our guys. But it is our story. We're going to continue to tell our story. This is part one of three videos that we have going.